Now, dear students, today we have the conservation of laws, and the four laws I have dictated here. First is the conservation of energy, conservation of charge, conservation of linear momentum, conservation of angular momentum. And one by one we are just explaining them. So first I have taken the explanation of the conservation of energy. So we have the basic statement, energy cannot be created or destroyed. It always transforms from one form to another form. Now, what are the suggestions and the examples we have? Now, we have the suggestion that energy of freely falling object. Always conserve. The question is that how can we say that? So I am just making the one of the pictorial diagram in front of you to explain the meaning. So now this is the one of the basic diagram, and already we have done this one topic in the 9th class. So I am just imagining a situation in which an object is falling from point A via a point B to the ground floor, that is C. Now, total height of an object from the bottom to top is the H, and this one is the distance X up to which A to B. Now, the mass of the object M, as we are just making the assumption, energy at A. Total energy is equal to sum of the potential energy plus kinetic energy. So we know that potential energy is equal to mgh, as the velocity v is the zero. Velocity v is the zero. So we are just imagining the kinetic energy zero. So the total energy will be in the form of the potential energy. So this one is the first specification. Now, energy at point B. So we know that total energy is the sum of the potential energy plus kinetic energy. So in the rest of part, this one distance is called the H minus X. So we can give the basic suggestion that how can we say that the conservation of the energy is possible. So we know that the MgH minus MgX, because it is be counted from the bottom part, okay, plus half mv square. Now, mgh minus mgx plus m upon 2v square can be stated in the term of the 2gx, because the object is coming down from A to B. The distance x is covered with the velocity v. So, the 2 cancel, this one fraction is cancelled. So, further we are just getting the suggestion that mgh is the total energy at the B. Now, energy at point C. Now, the total energy further in the term of the potential energy plus kinetic energy. So, potential energy mg into h is equal to 0 plus kinetic energy is equal to half mv square. And v square can be stated in the term of that, as the object is coming from A to C. So, we are just replacing the v square, that is m into 2gh n. This is the 2 cancel. Further, we are just getting the same kind of the result. So, we are able to say that by these three equations, now the equation number 1, equation number 2 and equation number 3, total energy of an freely falling object is always conserved. Now, example number 2 we have, in the absence of, in the एब्सेंस ऑफ फोर्सेस ऑफ फ्रिक्शन, फोर्सेस ऑफ फ्रिक्शन टोटल एनर्जी ऑफ सिस्टम रिमेन्स कंजर्व. सो दिस इज द सजेशन वी हैव. नाउ एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ द कंजर्वेशन ऑफ द चार्ज. सो द सिमिलर नेचर हैविंग द चार्ज नाइदर बी क्रिएटेड neither we create or nor we destroy. A charge it always transform from one body to another, charged body. Example, I am just taking the one of the nuclear reaction in front of you, that in the nuclear reaction, before the reaction and after the reaction, the total charge remains conserved. So I am just taking uranium-92 235 and there is a bombarding of the neutron on it. So it makes the two daughter nuclei barium and krypton with the atomic number 56, 36, 141, 92 plus 3 associate neutrons are there in result because it's a kind of the chain reaction. So we are just making the assumption of the atomic number, that means number of the electron before the and after the reaction. So simply we can say that before the reaction we have the total number of the electron 92. If you are just adding the number of the electron after the reaction, so 56 plus 36 plus there is a no kind of the charge on the neutron. So after the reaction we have the same number of the electrons. So electrons remains conserved in this reaction. Now another one example I am taking is simply a chemical reaction. Now deuterium 1s2 plus 1s2 is reacting and it forming the helium particle, that is 2He4 plus Q amount of energy because it's a kind of a simply nuclear reaction. So if you are just calculating the number of the electrons, number of electrons before the reaction and after the reaction, so 1 plus 1 make the assumption that is total number of electron, these are the 2, and after the reaction we have the number of the electron, that is complete 2. So this is the make the suggestion there is a conservation of the charge in any kind of the chemical reaction, even in the nuclear reaction. Now we have the explanation of the conservation of the linear momentum. So in the 9th class we have little bit discussed and I have put the one of the symbol in front of you. So statement, in the absence of external force, total momentum of system remains conserved. Example, now we are just imagining a collision. Of two objects moving along same direction. So what result actually we are getting? This one is a object number 1 is moving, it having the mass m1, its velocity is u1. Now this is the object number 2, it having the velocity, that initial velocity u2, mass is m2, both are colliding with each other and applying the mutual forces on each other. Now this one is having the mass m1 and m2. Then after collision, they are moving along the same path. Okay. But there is a little bit change in the velocity. So the object of mass m1 having the velocity v1 and object of the mass m2 having the velocity v2. So by simply derivation, we can assume that in the collision, there is a conservation of the linear momentum we have. So force on m1 due to m2 and momentum change now force on a 1 due to 2. So we are just writing this equation in the term of the second law of motion. So change in momentum m1 v1 minus m1 u1 is to be divided by in the small interval of time. So this is the one equation number 1 we have. Similarly, force on a 2 due to the 1 makes the change in the momentum of m2. So m2 v2 minus m2 u2 in the small interval of time delta t, it is called the equation number 2. So we are just utilizing the third law of motion by use of third law of Newton. For every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction with the symbol. So this one is the equation number 3. So we are use equation number 1 and 2 in 3. So we are just getting the simply nomination m1 v1 minus m1 u1 upon delta t is equal to with the minus sign. So I am using the bracket. Now m2 v2 minus of m2 v1 and the vector symbols are here in the delta t time. So we are just simplifying it and just imagining or transferring the terms. So we are just getting m1 v2. So this is the m2 u2. Okay. So we are just replacing the terms. So final result we are getting m1 u1 plus m2 u2 that is equal to the m1 v1 plus m2 v2. So it's simply the suggestion that in any kind of the collision or any kind of the mechanism, before the reaction and after the reaction, total momentum remains conserved. So it's simply the suggestion we have. Now another example we have. Momentum conservation gun and bullet system. Now we have next topic, that is explanation of the conservation of the angular momentum. So generally it's a kind of the rotational quantity. So we are using the second law of motion in rotational dynamics. So we are just writing, this is the symbol of the torque and it's simply the operation of the derivative, that is called the dy/dt. And we are just operating it on the angular momentum. So this is the basic formula which we are using. Now we are just saying that torque is a kind of the external torque on a system. External torque in the system, operation dy/dt, this is the operation of the differentiation. Later on we will discuss it thoroughly. Now we are just operating angular momentum of the system, total angular momentum of the system. We are just imagining there are the number of the particles in the system. So the each particle having the vector sum of the angular momentum. Okay, so this is the total angular momentum of the given system which having the number of the particle. Now we are just using the same hypothesis because still you are not aware about the rotational dynamics. So we are just assuming that this is the equation number one and this is the equation number two. If external torque on the system is the zero, then in the derivative part, the dy by dt of the constant will be the zero. So we are just using the simply hypothesis. So we are just using this one operation of the differentiation. So we can write at the place of the zero is equal to dy by dt of k is equal to dy by dt of that angular momentum. So this is the equation number three. Now comparing left hand side and right hand side in equation number 3, so L remains K, that is called the constant. So this is the explanation of the angular momentum. You are not too much aware about the angular momentum, so we will whenever we will discuss the rotational motion, so you will learn about that. Actually it is a kind of the analog form of the linear momentum in the rotational motion. In the linear motion we are using the nomination of the linear momentum P, and L is the momentum, kind of the momentum in the rotational motion. Okay, similar I have used the meaning of the torque, so it is a kind of the rotational force in the rotational motion. In the linear motion we are using the meaning of the force, that is called the F. So these are the this is the linear motion, rotational motion, linear motion term. So always we are just comparing the things. If someone is asked to you that what is the meaning of the force in the rotational motion, so you must tell that it is a kind of the torque. It is the force, but it creates the rotating impact on the body. In the linear motion, if we want to displace the thing, so what you should do it, now we are using the term that is called the force. So today we have discussed the explanation of the four terms. First is the conservation of the energy, conservation of charge, then conservation of linear momentum, and conservation of the angular momentum. I hope you are enjoying the topics. Now this is the completion of the chapter number 1. Now in the next lecture we will discuss the unit and the measurement. Thank you everyone.